freaking long full face of first impressions. Wow. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. Today, I practiced. It's a full face of first impressions. Wow, try saying that 10 times fast. Anyway, well, it's almost a full face. The only thing that's not new is brows, mascara and falsies. Oh yeah, and bronzer. The rest is actually new. So yeah, guys, I apologize in advance because it's going to be a freaking long one. A freaking long full face of first impressions. Wow. Grab a drink, grab a snack. Everything I use today will be listed down below. I crack me up. But you know what? Let's just go into the video and yeah, you can see how I achieve the look that I am rocking today. If you follow me on Instagram, you will have seen this one yesterday. So I have this one. So it's full face of first impressions, to be honest, because I'm trying out the Zodiac Aquarius, but I also have some stuff from the Catrice Spring Summer Collection, at least their new line that's coming into stores. So yeah, some stuff that is new that I picked up was this one. This is, I'm sorry for the shine, the Catrice Glow Illusion Loose Powder in Translucent. It's a fixing powder. I also found this, which is from their Liquid Camouflage line, but it's an under eye primer. And it says here,
Silky Smooth Hydrating Primer, which creates the ideal base for Catrice Concealer, reduces the look of fine lines and perfects under eye concealer application.
I think we have passed the fine line stage, but we will see what it does. They also had a new concealer. This is a one drop coverage weightless concealer, full coverage with hyaluron and sweat proof. I'm having hot flashes, so maybe this will be nice. So yeah, they had 4 shades, I believe. Not really sure, but I got mine in light beige. Then they had this one, which is actually one color. It's a 1 minute face perfector with magic finish effect. And it says here,
one fits all, moussey face perfector ensures flawless mattified complexion and natural makeup finish, makes pores visibly disappear, color adapts to any skin tone used as makeup or primer.
And I lately am more into kind of, well, just evening out my skin tone and let the rest be au naturel, well, face wise. Eyes not so much. So I thought, let's try that one. I also got 2 new lippies from their new line. This is the Generation Matte Comfortable Liquid Lipsticks. And they had a bunch of colors. I picked 2. I have here the Mauve to the Rhythm and Llama Pooch. Really? Llama Pooch? Llama Poo. Llama Poo. Let me swatch them. They are a bit cooler toned. I'm gravitating towards for lippies at least. I don't know, maybe a brownish cool thingy. This is Llama Poo. And this is 070 Mauve to the Rhythm. It's here. I think they're really pretty. I wore one yesterday and they take a little while to dry down. But they do dry down completely and they are not tacky and sticky and yucky. So yeah, I really like them actually. And they stay for a really long time. So I have 2 of those. What else? Oh yeah, I have another blush box. I don't know if the color is new though, or if I have just not seen it before. This one is in Glistening Pink. And it has a little bit of a shine. So here we have it. It's a lighter one. I don't even know if it shows up. But anyway, I'm going to try that one. I also picked up from Catrice the All Matte Plus Shine Control Camouflage Effect. Oil free. I don't know. I was reading about it and I was actually looking at the ingredients list. And I was like, maybe I need to try this one. I'm actually hoping that it is a dupe for my old L'Oreal Infallible formula. And that's a little bit of a spoiler alert because the foundation review on the new formula, so the 24-hour fresh wear, will go up tomorrow. And I picked up this one from Revolution, a vivid baked highlighter. And I have been eyeing this one for a while. It looks really pretty. Let me get it open. And it was on sale. So yeah, that's always a good thing, isn't it? This one is a little bit of a, I don't know, champagne-y. Ooh. So it's a very, I don't know. Let me swatch it here. Maybe not as blinding as I would have hoped, but we will see at the ending. So that is what is new, but let's start with priming my eyeballs first. Plop on that liquid primer underneath the eye primer thingy, whatever, because I have no idea if it needs to sink in. I do, however, feel a bit dry, so I'm also putting on a hydrating face primer. This one is from Max & More, but I actually kind of like it. It doesn't blur, which I don't want to. I do want, however, a little bit of hydration. Let me open the Catrice. Okay, so this is what it looks like. Well, let's plop it underneath the eye. Let me feel. Oh, okay. It feels nice. It feels hydrating. It feels smoothing. Oh yeah, I was actually planning on doing one eye with the primer and one eye without. So sorry about that. I'm going to prime my eyes real quick with the Catrice Camouflage Cream. Eyes are primed. Yes. And what I actually want to do as well is plop this one on. Or shall I do my eyes first? Let's do eyes first because the Love Signs palette has fallout. I don't know how this one is, but this is the Mini Zodiac Aquarius. And yes, it was not brown, so I needed it. Because I'm an Aquarius, my son is an Aquarius, and I needed it. I have been swatching this. It is, well, cardboard packaging. It comes with a mirror, but this is, I don't know, holographic. I don't know if you call that. But yeah, I have swatches on my Instagram. I do want to do a simple look today, a very quick simple look, because I have a lot of stuff. So I have an idea what I want to do. I'm going to start with the shimmer. So I'm taking a flattish brush. I am starting with this color. Let me try it dry first and see what it does. I'm going to plop it on my entire lid. It's actually really pretty and I don't have a lot of fallout, so that's good. Let's plop this on the other eye as well. Now I'm going to spray because I want to see the difference. To be honest, I don't see a lot of difference. It looks like this color is a little bit lighter than that one. Let's change brushes. I'm changing to a smaller detail brush. I'm going to go into this one, which is the darkest of the blue. I'm going to create kind of a, I don't know, halo-ish eye. So I'm going to plop this on dry as well. This is more of a gray. Also no fallout. Okay, I'm going to spray it on the other eye to see what it does. Yeah, it is a bit more foiled when you spray it, this one. Okay, let's get a brush to blend it all out. I'm going to go into the darkest brown, am I? Or the blue? No, I'm going to go into the darkest brown, which is this one. So it does have kick up in the pan. It feels really soft on the eye as well. Oh, that's pretty. Yeah, it's a pretty color. I'm going to bring this one down. I'm glad I didn't do my base yet because I'm really messy, apparently, today. I want it a little bit lower. taking a cleanish brush and I'm going to go over everything. It's a weird, I cannot describe this look today, but I'm going to do the same on the other eye. Let's get, just for funsies, the middle shade, the highlighter shade, that's really flaky. Let's plop that in the center. Something like that. So that is the eye look for now. And they blend it out so easily. I don't have fallout, so that is really good. Now I'm actually interested in this one. So the 1 minute face perfector. It is a pot and it looks like this. So I have a Q-tip here, a clean one. And I'm going to, it reminds me of chocolate mousse. Ooh. Does not smell like chocolate mousse though. Doesn't really, it has a scent, but it's not too bad. Okay, I don't know how much I need of this though. I want a little bit more, so I'm just taking a little bit on the fingertips. Well, it doesn't really even out my skin tone. Maybe if you put a lot on, I am, however, going to plop a little bit on my neck. I don't feel it's peeling. It's actually making my face feel soft, which I like. And it looks nice on camera as well. I'm actually happy with that. Let me try and build it up on one side. I don't know, just I have some on my finger. Put a little bit over the problem area. That's my cheek. Oh, it's not too bad, actually. Huh. Well, it is not a foundation, but it's not really bad either. And it feels nice, so that's good. Let's try the drops. The One Drop Coverage Weightless Concealer. I don't know. It is, maybe I need to shake it first. It is with a dropper, I saw. And let's just drop something on my finger. Very tiny dropper. Very liquidy. I have one drop on my finger. I don't know if the shade is correct for me, but wow. Wow. One drop. That was one freaking drop. I am impressed, actually. I'll go over it with a damp sponge. And this feels so weightless. Let me check in my mirror. Wow. Just let me get my magnifying side. It's not... You don't want to see yourself in a magnifying side, but still. Ooh, my under eyes. Wow. Yes, I have some creasing, a little bit. But because it is so thin, the formula, it's not really noticeable. Does that make sense? Okay, let's try building it up a bit. So I'm taking another single drop. And now I'm actually just tapping it on. And I'm going to leave it for a bit to kind of settle down. And maybe the color isn't really, really good, but wow, I'm actually really impressed. And it feels really comfortable. So I have no idea if this color is good for me. I got the color nude beige. I still have my liquid radiance to test out as well. Now, it has settled a bit. Let's tap it out. But oh my lord, this feels so weightless. And I think this is, if you can find your shade, because there aren't a lot of shades. This is something that is really nice to use if you want to have a no foundation day. You know, just a very, very light layer on your face. Goes a really long way. So this is, I didn't say, by the way, it's 7 milliliters. It's 0.23 fluid ounces. Ah, this one is with a pump, so that's good. Okay, this is a bit of a thicker formula. Let's dot it around the face. Oh, this is I think this is a lot. I don't think I need as much. I do think that I have an okay color though. So this is a medium coverage that I can build up, looks like. Wow, is this going to be the first foundation from Catrice that I actually like? And it could very well be the combination between with this one that I put on my face. So I definitely want to try the other foundations that I have from Catrice in combination with this face perfector stuff. Let's also bring it down. I do see a little bit of darker circles, not really when I look in the camera, but when I look in person, I can see kind of dark circles peeking through here. Yeah, weightless concealer. It says it's full coverage. The concealer, I don't agree, just because I can see darkness peeking through. But I do, however, really, really like that formula. So that's really good. Let's plop on a little bit of fixing powder. That's the trouble. I don't think I need to powder this down, to be honest. But let's try it anyway. Oh, and grab tweezers because, oh lordy lord. Oh, yes, please remove. I'm trying to remove you, you idiot. Oh. So here is the sifter. All right, oh, nice. Well, it's not coming out, that's what she says. So, do I have a little bit of powder now? No, god darn it. Let's see if I can, oh, I can pick it up. So, okay. I don't know if this is the best way to set my under eyes, but let's do it anyway. Okay. Translucent Radiant Glow Illusion, it's a fixing powder. Can I not use it as a finishing powder? Soft Focus. There's a little bit of a stickier powder, but I think I can use this as a finishing powder as well. But it is a little bit more of a stickier powder, if that makes any sense. So yeah, we have that one on. Okay, brows. That's also from Catrice. It's almost, really almost a full face of Catrice. It's just insane. Oh yeah, and the brow mascara that I'm using is also from Catrice. It's their semi-permanent brow mascara, but they have two new colors in this as well. So they used to have light, medium and dark, and now they have natural brunette and light brunette or something like that, but they have two new colors. So yeah. Okay, let's think about the bottom. Of the I want bright blue. Yes, I want this dark blue, the dark blue matte underneath my eye. Also a bit in the outer corner to deepen it up here. I like that. Okay, let's blend it a little. Yeah, let's get you. That's okay. Yes, inner corner highlight is, well, obviously going to be the big thing in the middle. And we're going to spray, or at least I am. And this one is a very, very crumbly, the big middle highlighter. Ooh, but it's pretty. If you spray it, it's really nice and shiny and foiled and goodness. Yes, I like that. So yeah, those are almost the eyes. Let me get some lash glue. Blush. Yes. Let's get the new blush box in the color. What did I say again? Glistening Pink. I don't see it really glistening, but I like the color. Let's use, bronzer. That one, let's grab Catrice because I have it here. Let's try the highlighter from Revolution. very yellowy. It is not as blinding as I would as I thought it was at first glance, but it is pretty. It gives a little bit of a more natural sheen, which is pretty. Let's see if I can buff with this foundation powder. I don't buff often, but sometimes I like to. Let's get this brush. So I have some powder, and let's just buff. And I like a fluffier brush for that. I actually wanted to try a more illuminating powder for buffing. One that I could easier get than the Flower Beauty one. What I'm going to do is liner, yes, and falsies. I will choose a lippy, then I will be back and we can discuss what I think about the product. So hold on tight, I'll be right back. Everything is on and I forgot, of course, to film the application of the lippy. I chose the Llama Poo. And it is really nice when you apply it. It feels really light. It's a light formula. My lips aren't sticking together, so that is good. I have a new pair of lashes on and they are kind of annoying me. The lashes I have on are the 3D Glams in style L12, but one is annoying me. Anyway, the rest of my makeup will be down below. Well, the rest of my makeup, it's only a liner, which is this one from Maybelline. It's their Lasting Drama Gel Eyeliner. Oh, I forgot to put on mascara. So yeah, let me do that too. This one from Catrice as well, the Glam and Doll Volume Mascara in Waterproof. So let me plop that one on real quick. So this is the look. How the look turned out, and also forgot to, yes, of course, I always forget earrings. Anyway, let's go over the stuff that I used. My under eyes feel really, really nice. Oh, what am I doing? I don't know. My under eyes feel really nice. They are looking nice as well. So I like the primer. I'm going to try it with my other concealers as well, to see how it works. I also am going to try it underneath foundation to see how it works, you know, the drill. So yeah, but I'm happy about that. The Catrice 1 Minute Face Perfector feels really nice as well. I think it makes my skin look pretty. And I cannot wait to try it underneath other foundations, to be honest. So yeah, that's the second one. What else did I have? Oh yeah, the concealer. I'm actually pretty impressed with that. The coverage it gives with the light formula that it has. Yes, shake before use. Did I do that or not? I don't remember. Probably not. But you saw I used a tiny, tiny amount underneath my eyes. And I think, again, that you can make it work. Well, if you have a no makeup day, something like that. Again, this is light beige. Maybe I need to get a shade darker. But so far, first impression is I really like it. And to be honest, I cannot wait to try the stuff that I have now with the Radiance one that I have. And maybe even the liquid coverage that I do not like that much. Or yeah, it's okay. It's not the best. It's not the worst. It's okay. But I actually cannot wait to try those two with this one as well. The foundation feels nice. I did not need to powder it down, to be honest. It felt good. It dried down. I like the coverage. It doesn't feel drying. I think it makes my skin look pretty. So yeah, I cannot wait to try this one out anymore. And so far it does remind me of the, oh, I'm itchy, of the old formula from L'Oreal. So that is good as well. What else? So we had that. The blush is pretty. It's a very light blush, light color. So I don't know that, I don't think that I can wear this one in winter or in summer. Maybe if I really build it up, because I did not really build it up, I feel. But yeah, I think the color is really pretty. I don't think it's really glistening, but yeah. And the formula is just amazing. The glow powder, when I just put it on, I was like, oh, it feels a bit drying because I did not think that I needed a powder. But it really does feel nice. I also used it to buff. You saw that I sprayed it and my skin feels nice. It does not feel drying. It doesn't look cakey. It doesn't look really luminous either, but I don't like that. I don't like a sheen on my entire face. So yeah, so far so good. The highlighter, I think it's really pretty, but it is more of a natural highlighter. It is not as blinding as some of the other ones that I have. Oh yeah, and then the eyeshadow palette, that's the last one. Oh no, and the lippy. Eyeshadow and lippy. They did a really good job with the aesthetics of it. The shadows are a very, very nice quality as well. The mattes worked dry and sprayed, or the shimmers worked dry and sprayed. The highlighter is, if you spray it, fantastic. I didn't put it on my face. I can though, just to see what it looks like. Where's my brush here? Ah yeah, oh, that's a lot more blinding. As is the highlighter in the Love Signs, but I can see now that when I put it on, it has a blue sheen. I thought it was a white, but it's not, it's blue. Let's blue my face up. I'm blue, la-da-dee-la-da-da, la-da-dee-la-da-da. So yeah, it is a bit blinding, isn't it? Ooh, now I'm buffing. Oh my lord. I don't know if this was such a good idea. I think I made a blue boo-boo. Anyway. You know what? I don't care. But yeah, I did not even notice that the highlighter shade was blue-ish. So yeah. Anyway, it does not really matter. But yeah, again, it's not the most inspiring palette for me. What I want to do with this one is a dedicated video as well. So try to come up with three different looks, which is going to be a challenge for me because this is a palette that is, well, quite monochromatic. Duh, it's blue. You have your brown shades, you have your blues, but I think that a lot of the time, a lot of the looks will come out somewhat similar. So it is going to be a challenge for me to create three distinctly different looks. And I think that's a nice thing to do. I'm already thinking about what I can do. So it's actually kind of inspiring, isn't it? Yes. But anyway, I'm going to do three looks with this and a dedicated review. And that was it. Oh Lord, my under eyes feel so nice. My face feels so, so nice. Oh wow. Anyway, the stuff that I used will be listed down below. And unfortunately that the shade range for Catrice is just still atrocious. So yeah. But anyway, oh yeah, the lippy. I'm all over the place. The lippy. I think that... Let me put it like this. The formula from Catrice, this one, their Velvet Mattes, is freaking amazing. I think this one is better. I love the color. It's not skipping, so that's good. It feels really comfortable. It's really light. It is like I'm not wearing anything on my lips. They had, I think, 12 colors of these. They had a bunch of different colors. They had light ones. They had, well, brownie ones. They had pinkish ones, a little bit of a more of a reddish type of color. They currently are having a Catrice sale here in store. So if you live in the Netherlands, Kruidvat has a Catrice second product half off, something like that. So yeah, I think I'm going to get some more lippies. And I think I'm going to see if they have this maybe in a little in a darker one. I don't know. I'm going to check it out. The powder I like I really like as well. So yeah, I'm really, really happy with everything that I got. So far, the final verdict is everything I used today for the first time, I like. First impression. Yeah, I'm going to try everything for longer and let you know in either dedicated videos or favorite videos, review roundup, maybe a whole update at the end of next month, something like that. So yeah. So this was it for me for my, full face of first impressions. Full face. Say that one 10 times fast. I dare you. Anyway, I'm going to sign off. I wish you a fantastic day. And I hope to see you tomorrow in my L'Oreal Infallible 24-hour Freshwear review. Foundation Friday thing. Wait. So this was it for my full face first impressions. Try to say that 10 times fast or something. I dare you. Yes, I dare you. Come on, do it. I'm not going to try. I'm not. Anyway, this was it for me. I wish you a fantastic day. And I hope to see you again tomorrow in my... No. So guys, this was it for me. And this was my... So guys, this was it for my full face of first impressions. Full face first impression. I'm not going to even try and go there. But yeah, if you liked it, give it a thumbs up. Let me know down below if you have anything of, what I tried today. If you are picking anything up. Unfortunately, I do not know if the new stuff from Catrice is launching in the US the same time as it is launching here. I don't know. I saw it in store and I saw it yesterday. So you just have to check to see if you can get some of the new stuff. It is worth it, first impression, in my opinion. Well, the first impression opinion or whatever. I'm going to stop talking now. I am going to stop talking. And I wish you a fantastic day or a wonderful evening, depending on when and where you are watching. I do hope to see you tomorrow in my Foundation Friday L'Oreal 24-hour Freshwear. It's another foundation that everyone is loving. So if you want to know if I'm loving it as well, you just have to check back on my channel tomorrow, won't you? And I'm going to say goodbye and have a wonderful, wonderful day.